eine du Sonnenschein, und damit dir im Wald allein. Weiter brauch ich nicht so glücklich sein, Wochenend und Sonnenschein.
Greetings, YouTube misfits, misgreens, malcontents, and misanthropes. Claire's here with her coffee. I'm trying to recover this morning from that spanking my basketball team received last night at the hands of UNLV. Ooh-wee, that's smarts. But I'm not going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about YouTube and YouTubers, so come on in and grab yourself a cup of coffee. At least my English football team managed a point at the Emirates against mighty Arsenal. You know, I heard an interesting statistic in that match. The announcers kept mentioning that Fulham had never, ever beaten Arsenal on their home pitch. Can that be true? I mean, both teams have been around since, oh, I don't know, somewhere in the late Pleistocene. Surely Fulham has beaten them at least once. But that's enough about sports, because I know most of my viewers could not possibly care less. Let's talk about YouTube. It's been a dreadfully quiet week on YouTube, frankly. I suppose part of it has to do with the American holiday of Thanksgiving. Many of us are traveling. Many of us aren't tuning in. Many of us aren't making videos. But frankly, I really didn't see a hell of a lot to shout out today, I'm sorry to say. So I guess what I'm saying is I do hope this isn't a long-term trend. Come on, guys, get off your ass. Make some videos that make me laugh or make me think in my declining years. So, having failed to receive entertainment from without, I entertained myself by stringing together a large number of clips from creationists that I've collected over the past couple of years. I hope you don't mind that I used a couple of clips that, well, I've used a number of times. It's just that they're classic moments. And I wanted to do a video that was kind of a narrative that illustrated how creationists talk about wanting to teach science, but really, in the end, they just want to push their faith. I suppose that if there's a crucial clip in that video illustrating the tragedy of blind faith and how otherwise intelligent people can simply turn off their logic function in support of a faith in the ridiculous, is this nugget from Emil Silvestri.
What is your educated guess right now in terms of the age of our planet?
Well, I'm not allowed to guess as an educated person, because my education would say it's certain that's 4.7 billion years for the planet, right? But that's not the kind of age I agree with. I can only trust one who has been there from the beginning.
Which is Emil's way of saying,
and God said it. That settles it.
And that is the punchline of every creationist video I have ever seen, and I've seen a lot. Despite the tortured attempts of people like Andrew Snelling or Emil Silvestri to dress up their religious faith in a pseudo-scientific frock and to put lipstick on their fabulous pig, ultimately, it's just about religious dogma. Sometimes, if you have the patience, watching a creationist try to square their religious faith with logic or with science can be very amusing. Such is the case with our first nominee today for a dim bulb of the week. Our first nominee today, Theus77, simultaneously maintains that God is crystal clear in his message, but that he also seeks to confuse those of us who use critical thinking skills, apparently for his own amusement.
You better be careful. God just might be leading you on a wild goose chase.
Really?
What he does is reveals the truth in such a way that a certain group of people are going to be... the truth will be hidden from them.
So I guess what you're saying is that for whatever reason, God likes to mess with some people, and he is hiding knowledge of himself from them, right?
And so you're dealing with rebellion, not ignorance.
So they do know the truth, but they're willfully denying it.
Once again, I believe God created in such a way to hide the truth from earthbound thinkers who are so wrapped up in intellect and intellectual ego and trying to find truth via just scientific inquiry.
Would that be the same suspect scientific inquiry that led to the development of that car you're sitting in or that computer you're using?
There's no room at all to compromise with any current scientific trends.
My impression is that you believe everything in the Bible is literally true. Is that correct?
Many people stumble over Genesis chapter number 1, but it's very clear that God clearly intended that it would be looked upon as 6 days of creation. You know, he talks about a literal Adam, which was roughly, 6 to 10,000 years ago. In the New Testament, he is part of the genealogies, the birth of Christ.
Here's some other scriptures. He says to Timothy again, don't pay attention to myths and endless genealogies, which give rise to mere speculation.
So I guess you're saying we should be careful of speculating. Would that be speculation of this sort?
Where did the supernatural part of creation end? Did God do anything supernatural in order to confuse us? You have the distant starlight issue, which did God do something strange and supernatural? Did he somehow make light get here faster?
The words cognitive dissonance come to mind, but my impression is that the S-77 has absolutely no discomfort whatsoever in holding self-contradictory points of view. Our next nominee, Dr. Andrew Snelling, is a real geologist. He's also a lying scum puppy. I briefly used a clip of him in the leftover turkey video, but I have so much more to share.
If we go to Colorado, the fluorescent beds, again we see insects, freshwater clamshells, fish, birds. I mean, how do you fossilize a bird slowly?
Is Andrew really that stupid, or is he merely being willfully obtuse? You be the judge. A bird is fossilized pretty much the same way most vertebrates get fossilized. That is, the carcass is laid down in an environment that impedes scavenging, rapid decay, and destruction of the hard parts. It is buried relatively quickly, and over time, the hard parts are either replaced by non-organic material or are permineralized by non-organic material. I now have a substantial collection of video clips from Andy Snelling. I'm probably going to have to do a whole video because, after all, like Emil Silvestru, he is a geologist and he deserves a thorough poning. But I do want to end this particular section of coffee with a little clip that kind of illustrates the limitations of Andy's knowledge.
Here we see a brachiopod, which is a lamp shell. It's a variation on a clamp.
Right.
Not only are brachiopods not a variation on clams, they're not even in the same phylum, you numpty! Our final creatard of the day is Dr. Jerry Bergman. Unlike most of the people that appear in the dim bulb segment of Coffee with Claire, he is an old Earth creationist.
Fossils are very important because Darwin based a lot of his theory on what he thought would be found, not that he saw, but that he thought would be found in the future in fossils.
Right. He thought the fossil record would either support or refute his idea of evolution. And the earliest known ferns have remained the same. We know for approximately 300 million years, it looks like a lot of life, most life, has not changed at all in hundreds of millions of years. And another example, an elm leaf, sycamore leaf, very distinct leaf, as you can see here from the fossil record. And the crinoids, they're invertebrates, they live in shallow water, and they're detailed, you can see, modern crinoids right here, and you can see in the fossil record. When you examine this under a microscope very carefully, you can see the enormous similarity, at least the external morphology is very, very similar. And a garfish, very distinct fish. You can tell that pretty quickly from many other kinds of fish. And again, you can see the same thing in the fossil record. Yeah, the point is very clear, and that is when we look at these fossils and compare it with modern day examples, we see virtually no change whatsoever.
Apparently, Jerry is incapable of appreciating that the succession of fossils he shows completely undermine his belief in a special creation by the God of the Bible. Unless he believes there are many special creations throughout geologic history, he is an old earth creationist. He accepts the geologic dates of the fossils he shows. And all he's demonstrated is that different groups appeared at different points in the geologic record. I find Jerry Bergman to be rather pathetic, but at least he recognized the legitimacy of geologic dating. I really wanted to give the award this week to Thea77 because I thought he was a thoroughgoing oaf. But in the end, I just have to give this to Andy Snelling.
Were you born?
Okay, don't forget there is a People's Choice Dim Bulb winner, and you can vote for which of the three candidates you think should be Dim Bulb of the Week. Voting continues till 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time next Friday. Speaking of that, last week's award winner was this fine specimen of manhood.
When a woman says that she was raped, she's pretty much lying. What really happened was that she asked for it, and she did something to invite it. And when she got it, changed her mind.
Michael is without doubt the most disgusting, steaming pile of crapulence I've ever featured in Coffee with Claire. On that happy note, I will see you later. I'll be back soon with some more videos. Bis später!